Obviously, a big marquee fight week here before UFC 300, before your fight against Yan Xiaonan. So I guess what are the emotions now that, you know, fight camp is over and you just have to weigh in and then fight on Saturday?
你的比赛马上就要开始了，那么现在在格斗周里头，很快呢就是倒数，你现在心情怎么样？有什么感想？什么感受？
我心情特别开心，然后也很放松，也很期待的这次比赛。
I'm very happy, very relaxed, and I'm really looking forward to the fight.
You fought on some big cards before in Las Vegas, Madison Square Garden, in Boston. So I guess where does this fight rank? Do you feel the magnitude of this fight week?
你以前也有在一些非常好的比赛中比过，比方说在纽约啊，在波士顿。那么你觉得这一次跟其他以往的那些大的比赛比起来，有什么不同？有没有更大的意义？
当然 ，UFC 300，12个前任冠军跟现任冠军，中国第一次的德比，这次是我职业生涯非常重要的一个比赛。而且我在 T-Mobile 之前在拉斯维加斯，我跟 Joanna 创造了年度最佳的比赛，然后我也非常喜欢拉斯维加斯。
Of course, because this UFC 300, it's a historic moment. We have 12 former and also current champions on this card. Also the first time two Chinese fighters fighting to get the belt, champion belt. Also, last time I was fighting in Vegas was against Joanna, and we had the best performance, so I'm super excited about this fight.
Do you feel the importance of this fight, given what you said, two Chinese fighters fighting for the title? Do you feel how important this is to your country, or do you also kind of just view it as just another title defense?
这次就像你说的，是第一次两位中国选手争夺这个冠军的头衔，那你觉得这是一个有特别的意义，尤其是你为你的国家在战斗，还是说这就是另一次卫冕而已？我觉得对，从我个人来讲，肯定是我觉得这是一场比赛，从不管从小男儿从我来说， 肯定是一场比赛，但是我觉得对于中国MMA来说，肯定是一个新的一个进步的台阶吧。
This is another fight for me, but on the other hand, this also means so much for the MMA sports development and growth in China.
Yan was in here and joked that more people back in China support you than her, so why do you think that is?
小南说，在国内支持你的人比支持他的人更多，那么对于这一点，你是怎么看的？
其实每一个人都有自己的粉丝，也有很我看到也有很多人支持他的，对，就是我觉得有支持他的，也有支持我的，每个人喜欢的选手也不一样。I
do see a divided fan base, but everybody has his own fan base.
In terms of her skill set, does she present anything that you haven't faced before in the octagon?
每个人都有自己的这个格斗的方式和长处。那你觉得小南她具备的一些特质，有没有你所之前没有见到过的？我觉得小南这两年她的摔柔和她的力量进步了非常多。I see Xiaonan that she has grown a lot, especially in her strength, as well as her grappling on the ground and everything. Yeah.
And final two for me. Can I get your thoughts on the fight between Alex and Jamal and Justin and Max?
你可不可以讲一下你对主卡拉几个比赛的一些看法或者说预测？我其实一般很少去预测比赛，因为我觉得在赛场上什么都有可能发生，而且就是看谁的状态更好。对。 I don't really like to predict outcome because anything can happen, and a lot of factors contributing to the outcome of the fight.
然后这也就是 MMA 的魅力，一切都是不确定性。
This is the beauty of mixed martial arts.
Weili over here. Weili, you were recently featured in Harper's Bazaar China. I was just wondering, how did you enjoy that experience of the photo shoot and the article they did?
Do you mind to repeat that question, please?
Yes, she was recently featured in Harper's Bazaar magazine in China. How did she enjoy the article and the experience of the photo shoot?
你好像有上过那个芭莎的杂志，然后她想问你一下你的你对那边 描述你的文章是怎么看的，然后感受是什么？
对，那篇描述我的文章，那篇文章描述了些什么呢？我要想一想。对，然后那篇文章描述了啥来着？
那你就说说你当时给巴莎的，就那个整个的经历，你的感受吧。
啊，我觉得巴莎它是一个非常专业的时尚的一个杂志，然后那次拍摄也是非常知名，在中国非常知名的摄影师帮我拍摄，也是我很早很早就之前的知道的一个摄影师陈曼，然后他帮我拍摄。
That's a very professional fashion magazine. Also, the photographer, she was very well known in China, so that was a great experience.
And then we know we've seen you obviously grapple with Francis Ngannou and picking him up, but you also got some work in and were training a bit with Merab. I was just wondering, how was that experience?
你有把那个铁血纳甘把他把
他说的是
把他举起来过？
他说的是纳甘诺吗？还是另外一个摔跤的选手，
他说两个人
哦，
对对对、
okay.
然后也说你跟那个梅拉布也有练过，所以说想问你一下对这两个感受是什么。
我觉得不一样的感受，我觉得抱纳甘诺的时候我没有觉得那么重，但是我跟梅拉布训练摔跤的时候，他的脚感非常非常的好，他的那个打摔结合也非常非常好，我也跟他学习到很多。
I did not feel Ngannou was that heavy, but when I was training with Merab, I was really surprised by how good he was on his ground game. Yeah.
Totally. Speaking of showing your strength and that, you also picked up Shaq back in September. Can you tell us about that experience with him and how difficult was it to pick him up?
他说我把那个谁把他举起来了是吧？然后呢？然后什么感觉？让我描述一下。OK， 他本来是，你有什么要 ？OK， 就是他很吃惊，我把他抱起来了吧。然后当时我觉得，可能他小的时候被妈妈抱过，然后长了这么大以后，估计没有人把他抱起来吧。我觉得。
He was quite surprised I was able to lift him up. I guess that maybe he was being lifted up by his mom when he was little, but never after became adult. So he was pretty surprised I could do that.
And of course, focused on this fight, rightfully so. But do you feel like Tatiana Suarez is the next contender after this, or is there someone else right now that you think is more deserving to fight the winner of this?
那这个比赛之后，你觉得下一个，如果你赢了这场比赛的话，你觉得苏亚雷斯是最有具有挑战权资格的，还是有别人？
我觉得看一看 UFC 怎么安排吧，因为我现在只想专注我当下的比赛。
I'll let UFC to do the matchmaking. Right now, I just wanted to focus on my fight.
Wally, you've had an incredible rise, becoming the first Chinese champion in promotion history right over here. Can you speak about your journey and your rise upcoming up to UFC 300?
你从最开始成长到第一位中国的 UFC 的冠军，可不可以大致的给大家讲一下你的这个成长的经历？
我成长经历，哇 ，long story， oh my god， 其实我简短的说一下吧，就是我把一个大的目标分成很多小的目标，然后不断完成小的目标的时候，我发现大的目标离我很近了，然后我也非常感谢 UFC 的平台，然后可以让我实现梦想。
I usually have a really big objective and I divide them into small goals. So as I achieving incremental goals, then I realize I am not that far from my big objective. On the other hand, I'm really thankful for the platform that UFC provided for me.
Back here. Speaking of training with Merab, I know you've been training at Syndicate MMA here in Vegas and John Wood is the coach over there. I've heard nothing but great things about the entire team there and John Wood. How has training there and being coached by John attributed to your success and your evolution as a fighter?
你就大致的谈一下你跟这位新的教练 John Wood 跟他训练的感受，然后你觉得他对你有什么的帮助？ We actually start working together since my fight with Carla. So we've been working together for a while. I think he's super smart, and we align on our vision, our style, how to train together. So it's been a very good working experience.
Whaley, the last time you were in Vegas was against Joanna in that epic fight. Are you excited to be back in Las Vegas?
提到了上一次你跟乔安娜在Vegas打，那你这次有没有特别兴奋，又回到了拉斯维加斯来参加这次比赛？
对，我特别的兴奋，然后可以再回到拉斯维加斯，因为我觉得拉斯维加斯是我好运的地方。
Yes, I feel this is my lucky place, my lucky city.